Yo, some great pictures from the Art Festival, man.
Yeah.
Yes, it's good. Thing on tomorrow. See you this time. Yeah, get all 16 of them for me. I'll say tomorrow. 16.
Let him know I'm waiting for him.
Okay.
All right, Tay. You pushing and pulling by yourself? Yep. I got you, man. Let me get my side. Wow, I got the Mike got the next. Hey, Freeze, you got any lift? Don't light. Here, take this. Don't get pushed. Take that. Yeah, tank it on that side. I got this side. Okay, I'm best back. Side on pass off. Give me
9.
Just match the hat, Mike. Match the hat, brother.
Yeah.
All right, don't pull. All yours. All right, cool. Pull that corner, hold up. So I drive, hold up, one second time.
This is where I usually go overboard, right here.
Yep, this last pull. Nice and easy.
Still haven't figured it out.
Just tap, tap, tap. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. Big Rick. Hey, bro. Oh, they over there scrappy too. Go ahead and park. Don't get into an accident looking back.
Okay.
got that rooming house up there by me, like a block down, half a block down from mine, man.
Man, I heard he's even crookeder than half the brothers out here.
You see that right there? Getting close.
Michael, can I ask you a question?
Yeah, shoot.
The tile is not flush against the wall over time when
that grout
holds it in place.
Oh, yeah,
That's all gonna hurt your running back again this week. You're gonna put him out against the whole season.
You know what's crazy? The RGT won't even really get a touch. He's out for the season.
Oh, no.
Yeah, he is.
We
were
talking about him yesterday while I was watching the game. Because, who y'all play? Carolina? They hurt too. They got an amazing concussion.
He's over 6 foot. Every player on our squad,
yeah,
I watched that
Jets and Buffalo game last night. Yo, this was battling out. Jets won 37-34. Buffalo got a nice little squad this year. We got a nice little black quarterback. Michael.
We all know Billy Clinton was first true brother.
Eagles ain't gonna never get a Super Bowl win. Cincinnati get one before they will.
But Cincinnati, then they took against the same team twice?
Nope.
Excuse me?
Nope.
They didn't took against San Francisco twice.
21-21. We only faced them once. We
played Frisco twice.
No, we did not.
We played one time with Steve Young and one time with Joe Montana.
We did not. When they played Joe once in the Super Bowl.
You played Joe once in the Super Bowl,
then
you played Steve Young.
Once in the Super Bowl.
And then you played Steve.
You better do that. I'm so confident. I'll put this money down maybe for the next Super Bowl. I'll bet you lose that one.
I only want it.
Google, how many times has Cincinnati lost?
Get a ring of quick Eagles in the ring. Y'all ain't gonna never get no more rings.
Chip Kelly fits perfect.
What the hell
they gotta do? We got a whole new offensive scheme, and we run a different offense. It ain't the West Coast offense we running no more. We running.
Boy, Chip Kelly, coach.
Yo, guess what? We gonna see
about Cat. Cat coming to second string quarterback.
Cat Ray snap. He gonna sit on the sideline.
Next thing you know, after the season, brothers be like,
no, he's not the general manager. He's the head coach. The head coach can't tell the general.
All right, so we're at the Christina Cultural Arts Center Mosaic Mural. This is a collaboration between the Creative Vision Factory and the Christina community. So we're ultimately this whole stretch of wall right here that's 6 feet high and goes from this end of the building to the door. This is 2 weeks of work actually on the wall. But it's been about 6 weeks of planning and 6 weeks of working on tile. So these tile right here actually have been made in a workshop setting. All the colored tile was actually hand-rolled at the Creative Vision Factory using a method called Sgraffito. Kids, members of the community, members from the Creative Vision Factory community are carving their very own designs into the tops of the clay. So the clay is it's a white-based clay. Painted with a glaze, and then while it's still drying, we can carve out the design. So the center panel of each one of these squares is filled with a diamond shape that's created with the Sgraffito tile and a combination of mirror. The outside of the square is covered in this broken beige tile that we're getting from like Lowe's, Home Depot, and other contractors. And then the bottom corners of each square has a cut, 4-inch cut mirror triangle. So by repeating this square
over and over again, when the square sticks together, those mirror triangles create a diamond shape. Another diamond shape is created with the beige tile. And it's going to continue for the length of the building. And ultimately, we're going to go 14 feet up. So when we're finished, we're going to be just above these windows. We're going to go the entire length of the building, over the back entrance door, and over to the other side of the building. And so, all told, it's like roughly 500 square feet of total mural surface here on the wall. So what the guys are doing on this far end right now, we just grouted this morning, they are feathering the grout off of the bricks and off of the mirror. So this grout is a mixture of sand and concrete, and we're dyeing it this purple color. So this is a method that we picked up from the artist Isaiah Zagar from Philly Magic Gardens. But this approach that we've been taking of making the tile making very collaborative in conjunction with Pristina Cultural Arts and having it form into this giant quilt pattern is the Creative Vision Factory contribution to this project. So it's going to be I feel like already it's a remarkable piece of public artwork here on the back of Market Street. So we're on Shipley Street right now. This side of the street, all the backs of these buildings that face Market Street, we see a collection of dumpsters and fire escapes. And doing a project like this, we're hoping that we can start to kind of creep up the street with public projects like this to brighten up this side of the street. And so also too, like getting back to the whole quilt idea, is that, you know, quilts are made with these individual pieces that you stitch together to create a uniform whole. And so right now, just looking at the number of hands that have been involved in this project, not only from the installation part, but also from the production of tile, we've had an exorbitant amount of number of people from the local community participating and actually having their hands in the creation of this piece right here. And I think that is really indicative of the mission of the Creative Vision Factory and the Christina Cultural Arts Center, that that together, by bring creative people and bring creativity in the arts to a larger community, together we can create something that's pretty magnificent. And so we're super proud of the project. We're about, I would say, a little less than halfway through. When we go up and finish these upper sections on the scaffolding next week, we're also going to paint this air duct that's right here, this metal pipe that's going up the side of the building. We're going to paint those with similar patterns to what you see on the mosaic mural to kind of camouflage them into the whole piece. But other parts of this that I really like is that, before we put this up, I really didn't think much about, this fire department connection sign, these pipes that are coming out. I think it's cool how it kind of becomes a part of the overall artwork when we're all done.
We first started, I started doing the mosaic projects with Ms. Nancy Josephson at the Creative Vision Factory for Antonio's Peace Garden. And once we got good with cutting glass and mounting them on bricks, this project came up with the mosaics with the ceramic tiles. So we took a road trip to Philadelphia. We met the guy that started doing it in Philadelphia on South Street. And we did on 8th and Tatnall, where Libby's is, right next door. It's an art studio. We did their stairwell going into the basement. That grew into this wall we created with the Christiana Cultural Arts Center, and we're going 14 feet high. Never knew that it would look so beautiful. And we get the different ideas from quilt patterns. And the quilt patterns are each square where there's a quilt pattern, that they're individual tiles, are all different personalities, all different people, from the children to the teachers to different people in the community. And once you stand back from it, you'll see the actual quilt patterns. It looks like one big quilt. And so we just take each square and picture in your mind the diamond shape, and you maneuver the tiles in the different directions in the different color schemes, some blues, some purples, some burgundies, some reds, and you make them fit together. And we've been having fun with it ever since.
Hey, Geraldo. Welcome to the ceramic part of the Creative Vision Factory. I'm here to give you a tour of what we do back here and what kind of things we make. We're going to start here. has a beautiful spinning wheel of the slab roller. This is where we actually make the slabs, roll out the clay that's going to become the tiles. So we roll the clay into a particular thickness, rolls through here like that, and then it comes out exactly the thickness we want, so they're all the same. Once we have the clay rolled out, we paint the clay in different colors. You can see when the clay, before it's fired, it's kind of a boring gray on the back, and this is kind of a pale pink. But this is actually going to be red. This is going to be dark burgundy. And these are going to be a lovely violet color. So we cut them into little shapes that work with the quilt pattern. Some small, some big. And you can see there's just tons and tons in here as we go up and up. Keep them lightly wrapped in plastic so they dry kind of slow. You don't want them to dry too fast. They'll tend to warp up and they kind of curve or they cup a little bit. We've also got some great designs in here. All kinds of people have come in and written things like Wall of Hope or drawn pictures of different animals or friends or sports teams, all kind of stuff. So we have a great mix all throughout there of tiles. These are all the red, burgundy, and purple that are going to go on the Christina Cultural Arts wall. So that's the color pattern we're doing for them. What those look like when they're finished, you have the burgundy, the rich red, it's really nice, and let's see, the purple. Sorry for the noise, it's a little dirty. There you go, a little more of a shine on it. So these all work together to make different patterns and shapes that are going to go up on the wall. And we mix that up with mirror and other broken tile. Now, getting it from rolled out slabs to this involves the kiln. So come over and look at the kiln. We have a fairly deep kiln, as you can see. It's quite a ways down. We fill it up with shells, so you build it as you go. You take a shelf and you go down into the kiln, set each shelf up, and then put stilts on top of it and put the next shelf and the next. So you build a whole little city in there of tiles and shelves and tiles and shelves. You can kind of see tucked in the corner down here, we have all our great shelves. We have the baby kiln here, which is great for running tests. It's really good if you want to see how colors are going to come out, but you don't want to do this much work. And it's rated highly for glass. So our future projects, we want to do some glass tiles, maybe make some formed glass like bowls and things, slump molds. So that's what we've got going on here. These are the stilts that we use to put shelf, stilt, shelf. So those are all the different heights that we can put between the shelves. And then over here, we have a different color set for a different project that we're doing in blues and purples. This is for a memorial for a young man of the neighborhood who passed away. Hopefully, as we go forward in the future, we want to fill up this space with all kinds of tile samples of different projects that we've worked on and different projects that we want to work on. So that's our dream, to fill this wall with are all our different kinds of tile. And that's what we've got. Any questions?
No questions.
Awesome.
Okay. Ready to get your drop master thing on tomorrow. Yeah, get on 16 on the foot. Let's see. Tomorrow. Dang. Boom. That's that thing master. Lane. Bad boy team. Let me get that boy on that ball. Whatever you want of them, people is taking your roles. House. This is his whole life. You know? Got some more pots I gotta fill out with them mirrors. Yeah. I'm putting him, Eric, I'm putting back. Yes, sir.
Yeah, right. So, he's got them big girls. He should be scared of little hammers. Okay.
Fill in the big spaces. Fundraiser. So far, all the members of her board are ecstatic over it, and everybody thinks it's like fucking phenomenal.
Because it is.
Yeah, our friend who's a nurse over at Planned Parenthood wants us to do the whole back of Planned Parenthood.
God damn.
Yeah, there's all kinds of stuff. So I'm telling you,
this is it.
A giant truck. We're gonna have multiple crews. We're gonna be doing Hokus and Versace water fountains. It's gonna be awesome.
I can't wait till we start using. You know, I bought a gallon of that hematite silver glaze.
No, totally.
Oh yeah.
All the stuff that fell, get it in a bucket and feeding it back up to us. Now, once we're applying the grout to the wall,
that's right.
Middle area right here, everything that falls to the ground, just let fall down, and then we'll bring it up. And it's, so as we move over, we want to let it sit for a while. So I mean, we probably won't need anybody working for like another half hour yet. 30 minutes, come back, and
we'll
start.
Alright. I'll go get Sam. You want to enjoy a cup of coffee?
Cool.
Alright. Let's go get Mike. Then after 30 minutes, you all dip off. And
yep.
Let me rock out my coffee.
Love it.
As it dry, you still can go back on it and still wipe the shit off.
Set it up and fall off. Make it double work. He's making it, like I told you, he's making it double work for it. But we got the one that come behind and clean up the shit.
Yeah. Ain't got no beer, bro.
That's it. Look, maybe look in the bin, then maybe go for the last time.
Tank
he's waiting for us to.
Oh, okay.
Nothing for him to do yet.
Sweet.
Alright, well, I'll let y'all need something. I'm gonna go start going through our tools and play.
Damn right.
fuck around and do something, put something on it. Mm-hmm. She said she ain't buying no more styrofoam.
It's coming out, I said, ain't that coming out of my pipe, out of my pocket.
You didn't, it's just coming out of the budget. Of what I'm saying, like, 20K a year. They get a certain budget every month. And when it comes alive, you gotta spend all that money.
Use a rag!
The rag ain't the same thing, cousin.
No, it's not.
What are you just gonna pop right?
Yeah, I'm just videotaping.
So, right,
I'm doing a documentary.
Okay. Well, that's
right.
It's
quiet
in
there. Hey, Mr. Mike, after the Porter Center, right?
Right.
I ordered your number, but they sent it back.
Where'd this piece go? That's fine.
Tomorrow. I got a small one right here. Hey, Mike, how you looking? Good.
We fire it together, so they'll both go on the wall in the same place.
Oh, okay. Why did I think this was longer?
email to you or whatever.
Oh my God!
There you go. Something's happening. What's happening out there? Okay, we're currently using two firings, two users, user one and user four. User one is the glaze firing, user four is the bisque. User four. Four is the bisque.
One's glaze.
One's glaze, exactly. So, and the way you would know that is because when you do this thing, when you hit enter program, what it's wanting to do is review the whole program with you. And the next thing it'll say is segments. This has a 3-segment. And you just have to sit here and run through the whole program. Alarm is always the last thing. And then you could press start. Mm-hmm. And what it would do is it would start the glaze program. Mm-hmm. As it happens, we don't want it to do that. You know that it's working when it flashes on, which it did a second ago, and then it'll start turning things on. I'm going to stop that now. So what we're doing today is the user 4. So enter program, user, press 4, enter. And now you just have to run through the program. If you wanted to know what it was, no, enter. So it's ramp 1, degree of 1, hold 1, ramp 2, degree 2, hold 2, ramp 3, degree 3, hold 3, 4, 5, because it says 5 ramps. Alarm, enter, hit start stop. It says on. That is what we want, is the magic. So, what did we put it on, user 4?
Mm-hmm.
Great. So that's it. It's on.
That's it.
So you'll do the same thing Monday. You'll just switch it back to user 1.
Turn this on?
Yep. And the switch on the thing. That's the by far the more important one, is the switch on the 4. The story, for those who want to know, the segments or ramps, there's... The main way you heat up a kiln is you go up in certain, like, degrees per hour. So at certain temperatures, like when it's low, you don't want it to get hot too fast because the steam in it will evaporate and blow it apart. So it always moves up really slow. Ramp 1 goes up 50 degrees at a time to 100 degrees and then holds there for 2 hours to boil out the water at 100 degrees. 2 goes up to 200 degrees, so you're just under boiling point. Holds there for a while. 3, now we're fine. Now we're past the boiling point. It can go up at 200 degrees an hour, up to 300, and then it shoots up to 1060, 1728. Holds at 1728 for 15 minutes, and that's it.
Just goes back down.
Yep. Slowly, by itself, all flows the way in its enclosed thing. It goes down. It takes about 24 hours. You don't want it to go too fast because everything will chatter, and you can't crack the lid. And the glaze thing, so this is 5 seconds because it's going up and then jumps based on the water coming out. But when it's glazing, it's on.
I feel you, man.
Was bent over with a Pittsburgh Steelers drawers on and had
a mouth.
I feel you, man.
Was bent over with a Pittsburgh Steelers drawers on and had
Robert Ryman. Can I keep you on the phone while I do this? We're all loaded up. Okay. So it's enter program. Wait a minute. Enter program user. So I hit enter program. It's flashing user 4. So do I just hit the enter program until I get to user 1? Yep. Got it. It's on. Yep, thank you.